Hey, what's up everyone? GameDad here, and today we have another video sponsored by the folks over at Extreme Rate. And what we're doing today is a shell swap on a Nintendo Switch Lite. Now, Nintendo consoles can be notoriously difficult to work on because they got about a billion screws in a billion different sizes, so they can be rather annoying at times. But I'm going to show you the process. It's not going to be super in-depth or detailed, but I'll give you some top-down footage of what is going on, and we'll kind of speed through it. That way you don't have to sit through a super long video. But we're going to get this swapped over to a nice, new, colorful... You know what? I'm going to wait. You can wait until the end to see what this Switch Lite is going to look like. I think it looks awesome. The shell feels really nice in the hands. So without further ado, we're gonna dive in and we're gonna get the shell on this Switch Lite replaced. Thank you. Well, there you have it, folks. We have a new Switch Lite case. I think the case looks really cool, actually. It's got a nice new screen protector on it that helps add to the aesthetic. As you saw, I was able to go in, test, make sure all of the buttons worked again. I will say the ABXY at first weren't getting recognized and had me a little worried, but once I gave it a minute to boot up, then everything worked fine and all buttons are working. And yeah, this has a new case. Now, it is nothing against Extreme Rate. The case is great, does exactly what you want it to do. Boy, this thing sucks to do a reshell on. This was a huge pain. As you saw, as I was taking it apart, there were literally, I think, like 60 screws. I mean, this is the little baggies they give you with brand new screws. Too many damn screws, and I would recommend, I just had them kind of in sections as I was laying it out. I would recommend a mat and write down what each thing went to, because at one point I forgot where a screw went. I ended up finding where it went, so that was good. But this thing, huge pain in the butt. If you have never done a reshell before, don't start with this one. Start with something, you know, a little simpler, like a controller reshell, like I did in a recent video. But is it hard? No. It takes time and you just need to be well organized. It's not hard, it's just, it takes forever. But with that being said, we got a nice new Switch Lite shell. Here is the old one, it was the standard teal. And now we have this cool like purple to teal gradient going on. Now, this is for one of my daughters, and then I have another one that I'm going to do with a slightly different color scheme on it. One, so they can tell them apart, and two, just because the other color scheme looked cool too, so I wanted to try that one. But huge thank you, as always, to Extreme Rate for sending this over. It looks great. It was kind of a pain. Not your guys' fault. It's Nintendo's fault for using a million different screws. But overall, excellent reshell. I don't know what to call these. They're not a mod per se, but they definitely breathe some new life into it and make it look really neat. So if you like this video and you like stuff from Extreme Rate, check the link down in the description below. And if you want to see another recent video that I did, then go ahead and check out this area right here. And as always, I'm GameDad. I thank y'all for watching and I'll catch you later.